Disney, you blew it. People have been saying for a while now that your live-action adaptations of beloved classic animations that you made suck ass. I will confess that I think the Jungle Book live-action film was good. Was it as good as the classic cartoon from years ago? I don't know. I was a child when I watched the Jungle Book and I haven't seen it in years. However, on its own merits, I think the Jungle Book was a good film. However, each subsequent live-action film has received mixed to negative responses, and people are pointing the finger at Disney and are saying that they are only making these films to squeeze as much money juice out of the IP as they possibly can. Then along comes Pinocchio. Now don't lie. You like Disney. You say you don't, but you must like at least one of their films. Okay, I know you do. I don't know what kind of childhood you would have had if you don't like at least one of them. Now it seems like Pinocchio is one of Disney's most popular animations, mainly because the film terrified them as a kid when all those little kiddies got turned into donkeys and the one donkey was screaming for its mama. I also like Pinocchio. It has been a while since I saw it, but I do remember it very fondly, and I do remember the film's story, and overall I think it had a great message. Disney, in all of their wisdom, thought that they could reinvent Pinocchio for modern audiences, and it turned out that they couldn't. In fact, Disney's new Pinocchio is a bit of a disaster. It's not very good, and it was able to unite fans and critics in calling it a soulless turd. Fans and critics rarely completely agree, and I will admit that whilst I think the fans are usually right, they're not always, and sometimes I agree with the critics. But in those rare moments where the stars align and both audiences and critics agree, that is when true peace is achieved. No one likes this film, or at the very least, no one likes this film anywhere near as much as the original. Then enters Guillermo del Toro into the SmackDown arena. Guillermo del Toro, best known for his appearance in Hideo Kojima's Death Stranding, is a director that I'm fairly familiar with. I haven't seen all his works mainly because I'm not a fan of horror, and I don't want to go watch a woman bang a fish whilst General Zod watches from the sidelines, but I do love both of the Hellboy films and I think Pacific Rim was alright. However, what drew me into wanting to watch this film was the man's clear love and passion for the film that he was working on. Seeing how much he genuinely cared about the film made me want to go see it and support him, and I'm really glad that I did because I really like this film. It really moved me. Now, to be fair to all of you, I watched this film with my family and none of them felt the same. They were all actually really disappointed by the film and kept saying that it was not as good as the Disney original, although I did keep reminding them that the Disney film was not the original. Did you know that in the original story that Pinocchio murders Jiminy Cricket in a fit of rage by bludgeoning him to death with a hammer? You might think I'm joking, but Pinocchio genuinely killed Jiminy Cricket in the original story. In fairness to my family, there were times where I also couldn't help but compare this Pinocchio to Disney's classic, and sometimes it did make this new one seem weaker. Specifically with Jiminy Cricket, who didn't leave anywhere near as much of an impact on me as he did in the Disney one. But overall, I was able to watch this film as its own separate entity, and I really liked some of the changes they made. For example, I loved everything to do with the war, and it was Candlewick's parts in the film that were responsible for moving me close to tears. Just seeing a young boy drop his shield and open up about how he truly feels really got to me, and it was the emotional highlight of the film for me. I loved seeing the culmination of the build-up of Pinocchio's relationship with Candlewick as the two got off on the wrong foot, but ended up becoming truly great friends. Pinocchio in the film is so sweet and kind, and he really feels like a child trapped in a wooden body. You can totally see how the villains in the film could easily take advantage of him and use him for their own desires. The two major villains of the film, Podesta and Count Valpe, are the standout characters of this film. Podesta is a Nazi and acts exactly how I envision a Nazi would have acted back then. He's very strict, never cracking a smile, and demands discipline and perfection from those around him. Anything that strays from the true path is a great offence to him. However, I like that he felt human and not like a two-dimensional character of a Nazi. Everyone hates Nazis, you just need to see the red armband for your brain to automatically fill in the blank that this guy is not a good guy. However, in this film, both Geppetto, a character I liked in this film way more than I remember liking it in the Disney version, and Candlewick, a character that I've already spoken about how much they affected me, both do a Nazi salute in the film. While Nazis are absolutely presented negatively in the film, the people working under the regime and living in these occupied countries are not presented so black and white. I was genuinely curious as to which direction the film was going to take Podesta, as I could see him turning his back on his ideals to accept his son, whilst I could have also seen him being so ingrained in his beliefs that he would actually shoot his son for not being who he wanted him to be. I won't spoil Podesta's storyline as I believe this is the best part of the film, and also Ron Perlman is a really good voice actor. I didn't realise that it was him who was voicing the character. Count Valpe is played with great menace and charismatic gusto by Christoph Waltz. I think Count Valpe is the most memorable character from the film in my opinion, and I love the way his character exits the film. It's so brutal and the sort of thing Disney would definitely shy away from. He's so manipulative and I love that they don't underplay the brutality of his abuse. He's a very evil man and the film isn't shy about showing it. Whilst I really liked some of the characters and additional story beats, the true standout of the film is undoubtedly the stop motion animation. It is beautiful and the animation is so fluid and expressive and all the emotions of the characters were able to come through. It is objectively excellent. The time it must have taken to get this film done properly is so awe-inspiring. Like I said, Guillermo del Toro was very passionate about this film, and his choice to make this film one with stop-motion animation reflects that, in my opinion. This is a film that was in production hell for quite a while, yet Guillermo del Toro persevered and delivered this wonderful film to us, and I'm so happy that he did. If I had to fork myself to come up with a few negatives for this film, then there would be that I wasn't as keen on Jiminy Cricket. I felt like they could have removed him from this film, and it overall would remain the same. Whilst I liked most of the story changes, I wasn't super thrilled by all the afterlife stuff, although I didn't dislike it either. It was just a change that I felt very met about, and part of me really wishes that, spoiler for the ending, that Pinocchio actually turned into a real boy at the end. And finally, the songs weren't very good in the film. I can't remember any of them except for the My Son, My Son one. However, aside from these very minor gripes, I love this film a lot, and it made me feel for a boy made out of wood. And whilst I kind of wish he was human at the end, I did like Pinocchio's ending. This is a very good film and a very tragic one too, but also a very hopeful and happy one. I can't say for certain that this film will connect with you like it did for me, and I can't say that it will necessarily leave the same impact on you that the Disney classic did, but I'm sure that this film will touch someone out there in a similar way that it touched me. Anyway, I hope you enjoyed this film, and also the Disney classic, not the new live-action monstrosity, and I hope to see you in the next video. Bye-bye!